Hi. Yes, are you ready to check out? How many? You can check out as many as you would like. And we have no late fees. Yeah. Okay. I can certainly check you out. Do you have a library card? No? Okay, I can help you create one. Yeah. Okay. Let me back out. May I have your first name? Okay. And your last name? Okay, that's a very interesting last name. Okay, we're still spelling. Okay. Okay. Wonderful. May I have your address? Is that lane or drive, street, place? Okay. Zip code? Okay. Wonderful. And last, can I get a good cell phone number for you? This way we can text you when the book needs to be returned. Okay. If you don't want to receive text messages, that's fine. You do? So that will just sign you up. Okay. And let me just go ahead and type in some of the usual information that we need to fill out for everyone. Things I can just see by looking at you. Hair color. Eyes. Do you mind looking closer? Eye color, okay. I'm not quite sure why that's important. And your social. That we do need. That is not optional. If you want to borrow books. I feel like that's not a real social security number. That's fine. I don't think that we really check into that, you know, unless you just simply haven't returned a lot of items. Okay, and may I have have your birthday. You actually look a lot younger than that, yeah. Okay, so I can get you checked out for today, and then you'll receive a card in the mail. Yes? Okay. Did you have any trouble finding what you needed? Do you mind if I just take these? Okay. Okay. Yeah, we don't have a limit. You can take as many as you need. So this one. This is one I have read. This one's pretty good. John dies at the end. Have you seen the movie? Yeah, the book is always better. So, since this is your first time, I need to input a lot of information manually. Since you don't have a card to link everything to. So, need to search this book in our system. Okay. There it is. Right there, okay. And let's see. Input in the ISBN number. Wonderful. And since we do not charge late fees, I do need to go through the book just to make sure that I understand the condition of the book when we lend it to you, and then it will be reviewed once more when it is returned, and that is whenever you would like to return it. Okay. And I'll just flip through. No markings. And take a look at the spine. No real indention or crease in the spine. Wonderful. So, I'm sure you will enjoy this. Tender is the flesh. I have read this one. I heard wonderful things about it and just decided I had to read it for myself. So this one's a bit tricky to look up because it is from Spanish to English translation. So I'll search it by the author's name. So last name. Basterica. Agustina. Sometimes they also will list it with her translator, which is Sarah Moses. Okay, I see it. I see it there. There are a few scratches on the front. I'll notate that. How did you hear about this one? Seems like you have good friends. Beautiful. This one looks exquisite on the inside, not so much on the outside. That's okay. What's important are the words inside. Oh. Nature Girl by Carl Hyacin. I haven't read this one. I do enjoy his books though. I'm going to read the back. It says, "Beware. Honey Santana is off her meds, reacting rapidly to the bad behavior of others. This time, the annoyer is a telemarketer from Texas. Honey's revenge? She invites Boyd Shreve on a paid eco-tour of the Everglades, where a blue-eyed Seminole named Sam My Tiger Tail strums an electric guitar on a woe-begotten clump of shells, mangroves, and beer cans called Dismay Key. Soon, Boyd and Vengeance Crazed Honey are joined by a private eye with a red-hot video camera and a college girl who just wants to have fun, and with a brawling cast of lunatic men, desperate women, a skateboarding teen, and even a restless ghost, all going native. Who will protect the Everglades from the wild humans?" I believe Carl is from Florida. I think most of his books are written about that area. Okay, wonderful, I found it. So I will say the corners kind of curve up on the bottom right, so I'll notate. Okay, so it looks like we have a bit of water damage here. The pages kind of curve up. So it looks like it starts around page 209. Scroll down to the water damage section, so 209. And it continues. It's pretty bad on 214, so. I'll say to about 218. Okay. Wonderful. Looks good. One's for you to check out here. Alright. And now, Doomed by Chuck Palahniuk. An autographed copy. Wow. Madison Spencer, the liveliest and snarkiest dead girl in the universe, continues the afterlife adventure begun in Chuck Palahniuk's bestseller, Damned. Just as that novel brought us a brilliant hell that only he could imagine, Doomed is a dark and twisted apocalyptic version from this provocative storyteller. Yes, Chuck is very, you can just tell what he has written, even if you didn't see his name on the cover. I am curious to see what that signature looks like. Wow. I wonder if that's real. That's pretty cool if it is. Let me see if we have it documented. Search ISBN. Oh. It's a little net in here. Okay. Yeah. There it is. Okay. This one also appears to be in pristine condition. So I will leave no notes and expect to see this returned in the same condition. No pressure. This is quite the book. This will take you some time to read. Yeah. The Ultimate Hitchhiker's Guide. 5 complete novels and 1 story. Oh, let's see. The Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy, The Restaurant at the End of the Universe, Life, the Universe, and Everything, So Long and Thanks for All the Fish, Mostly Harmless, Young Zaphod Plays It Safe. What a lovely cover. All right. So let's see which copy this one is. Wonderful. The pages are nice and gold. Right. Okay. Very thin. The history of the Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy is now so complicated that every time I tell it, I contradict myself. And whenever I do get it right, I'm misquoted. Very interesting. How to leave the planet. Beautiful. So these pages here look just a little bit snagged, so I want to note that. From page 458 to 469. Okay. Well, here you are. And you are free to take these with you. Please return them when you are done reading them. There is no return date. If there is someone that has come looking for a book that you have checked out, we will text you, letting you know. If you could maybe hurry up a little, return it so that it can be read and enjoyed by other people. Sorry, I misspoke. I said no return date. We would like it back within 3 weeks. It is not enforced, but just a guideline. We have learned the more freedom that we give to people, the nicer they treat our things, and they do typically return books within a timely manner. So I anticipate the same from you. Yes. Hold on. Let me close this out. Did you want a receipt? Can email it to you. What's your email? Okay. And then it's dot your last name. I'm sorry, you're gonna have to spell that. Beautiful. All right, I've sent it. Okay. All right, well, I look forward to seeing you again.